Hi, my name is Sarah Safari, and I'll be walking us through a MCAT psychology passage, and I'll just be going over the tips and strategies that I used when I took the MCAT specifically for a psychology passage, and we'll be going over it slower than you would normally want to go over an MCAT passage, just to give you guys the full picture and so I can talk it through. So let's keep that in mind and let's get to it. Okay, so before I go into reading the passage, I just want to go over my strategy for when I read. So I don't typically like to underline lots of things because I find that when I go to the questions, the passage becomes cluttered and I can't find anything. And if I am going to underline something, I'll only underline the first portion of it. But for the things that I do underline, it would be related to anything talking about a study protocol, like sample size, control groups, things like this, or something related to an abbreviation. The first time it's abbreviated and then every time it shows up in a passage. So let's get started. Researchers have discovered that childhood exposure to secondhand smoke can have detrimental effects on a child's health and development. Studies have shown that secondhand smoke can, 1, increase adulthood incidence of asthma, 2, decrease dopamine levels during adolescence, 3, affect cognitive processes like decision-making, and 4, increase adulthood incidence of cancer. To study the effect of secondhand smoke during childhood on adult health outcomes, because this is the whole point of this study, I'm going to underline it, researchers conducted a longitudinal study tracking 938 individuals who lived in homes from ages 0 through 10 with guardians who smoked at least one pack a day of cigarettes. As a control, researchers also recruited 912 individuals who lived in homes from ages 0 to 10 with guardians who did not smoke any cigarettes. Beginning at the age of 15 through the age of 60, the researchers sent a survey to the study participants to assess any physical or mental health conditions that the participants had, such as asthma, hypertension, diabetes, schizophrenia, depression, anger issues, or cancer. In the group that experienced secondhand smoke, so the experimental group, researchers found a higher incidence of all 7 physical and mental health conditions that were outlined right here. The greatest difference between the two groups was found in the incidence of asthma. So I'm going to go back and circle it just for emphasis. 54% of the individuals in the group that experienced secondhand smoke developed some form of asthma by age 60, compared to 23% of the control group individuals. Researchers also found that individuals in the secondhand smoke condition developed schizophrenia by the age of 60 at a higher percentage than control group individuals. So that's schizophrenia as well. Let me zoom in a little bit for you guys to see. I'm also going to underline schizophrenia more as well. So, in a follow-up investigation, researchers decided to broaden the scope of the study to analyze socioeconomic factors. Using average household income and neighborhood public school funding as a proxy for socioeconomic status, researchers found that low socioeconomic status individuals had poorer health outcomes irrespective of secondhand smoke during childhood. So, not depending on that secondhand smoke exposure. So, let's go into the questions. A researcher points out, actually, before I read the question, I typically will like to think of the answer to a question before I look at the answer choices so I'm not influenced by them. So, let's go into the questions. A researcher points out that there's a difference in the size of the secondhand smoke group and the control group, which would invalidate the results of the study. The concern is blank. So first, I want to go back to my passage and see what were the sizes of the secondhand smoke group and the control group before I read any of the answer choices to be swayed. So here I underlined the control group, the experimental group has 938 participants and the control group has 912. So here we go. It was 900 and 38 here, and then the control was 912. So the difference is 20 or so individuals, but this is a huge sample size, so that many individuals is not really going to make a huge difference in terms of study sample size. If, let's say, for example, the experimental group had 50 people in it and then the control group had 20 people in it, then that's something more concerning. So I don't think that there is a concern here. So now let's look at the answer choices. Valid, because the sample sizes must be equal in order to achieve statistical significance. That is not true. So we're omitting it as an answer choice because sample sizes do not have to be exactly equal. B, valid because these unequal sample sizes will produce bias. Once again, this is basically saying the same thing as A. Unequal sample sizes, it depends on how unequal they are if they will produce a bias. You don't really have a calculator to see statistically if what exactly the cutoff point is, but this is a small enough difference that you can use your own reasoning to see that this is okay. So B is incorrect. So now we're going to the invalid options. We know it's one of these two, so we need to make sure that the reason it's correct, the reason that it's invalid is the correct reasoning. Invalid because a difference of 26 individuals for two large sample sizes will not be significant. This is pretty much the explanation I gave to you guys when I read the answer choice. So this is looking very like a good answer. So let's look at the last one just for completeness. Invalid because statistical significance is not based on sample size. That's incorrect because statistical significance is based on sample size. So that's wrong and C is correct. Moving on to question two. Which of the following most likely explains the increased incidence of schizophrenia in the secondhand smoke group? So going to the passage, I did underline schizophrenia here. And this requires some knowledge about schizophrenia, and it is related to dopamine levels. And also, if that is not knowledge that you have, also right here in the passage, we see that secondhand smoke has shown to decrease dopamine levels. Dopamine is the only neurotransmitter that is mentioned in the entire passage. And based off a knowledge of schizophrenia, we know that it has to be the dopamine hypothesis. And then just looking at the other answer choices, serotonin is involved in depression. Acetylcholine is not involved in schizophrenia, mostly is in Alzheimer's. And also, acetylcholine and epinephrine hypotheses are not commonly used. It's mainly dopamine versus serotonin, and in the case of schizophrenia, dopamine is the correct answer. Last question. In a new study, researchers discovered that individuals with low socioeconomic status experience worse health outcomes than individuals with high socioeconomic status. This result is best explained by which of the following? So I can already tell that this question requires knowledge of terms. So let's see, gender inequality. While we're talking about socioeconomic status, we're not talking about gender here, so this does not make sense. Food deserts, option B. This could be a contributing factor, but I don't see it being the best answer choice. Socioeconomic gradient of health, this is the best answer choice here. And epidemiology is the study of disease trends in the population, which does not make sense here. So the answer is the socioeconomic gradient of health. This is the most correct answer. And if you're just concerned about food deserts, there are more food deserts in low socioeconomic areas, but this is not the most correct answer. Socioeconomic gradient of health would best explain why individuals with low socioeconomic status experience worse health outcomes. If you've enjoyed this walkthrough, be sure to like this video and subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss out on our future MCAT videos. Be sure to also check out our high-yield strategies in our MCAT 528 series and click the link in the description to sign up for practice questions so that you can get every last bit of practice in before test day. Happy studying!